This is Christian with Outdoor Game Cameras, and today I'm doing an unboxing and a quick setup with this new 2022 Browning Defender Pro Scout Max. This camera just came out, so let's go ahead and talk more about it and get this camera set up. This camera operates for 1 year on 8 AA batteries. We have this new Retina 6 high-powered infrared night illumination dual carrier device. Camera can be configured for AT&T or Verizon networks. This camera is 4G LTE, 20MP pictures, 0.25 second trigger speed. We have 1600 by 900 HD plus videos with sound. We have 110 foot IR flash range. We have GPS tagging images. We have 512 GB SD card support. We have adjustable IR detector range up to 100 feet. Multi-shots, updated images, zero blur technology. We have transits pictures, standard or HD images directly to your laptop or your mobile device. Here's the cellular plans and features. There's different plans, all depends on how much you want to spend and how many cameras you have. So you have your Scout Plus, Hunter, Hunter Plus, and Guide Pro. Then you have your pricing, image uploads, all depends on how many uploads you want to. And then you have your HD image uploads, and then a video uploads. Now this camera does not upload videos with the app, but it does take videos, and those videos will be on your SD card. So do keep that in mind. And then you got your camera per plan. So you can go all the way up to 6 cameras on the Guide Pro. I'll probably end up with that this year because I have a lot of these cameras. And then all data stored on secure servers located in the United States. And then so if you want to add like more cameras to your plan, so if you go with the Guide Pro, so it's going to be like $49.99. And then if you add a camera, it'll be $5 more on top of that. So it's really not too bad. And so if you think about like going out to your location, that's not a bad deal. We have the easy three-step camera activation, create account, scan QR code, complete checkout. And then we have your cellular feature list, and then you have your camera feature list. So let's go ahead and talk more about those. This camera uploads standard and HD images, GPS tagging images, email, text images, security mode uploads, images in standard or HD sends you alert. I'll show you how all these settings work in the quick setup. Create unlimited folders to organize images online. Sort images by time, date, moon phase, temperature, month-to-month data plans. Easy to use mobile app for tablets and smartphones. Activate cameras only when you need them. Activate multiple cameras on the same data plan. No contracts. Outputs includes economy, long range, and fast motion. Picture info bar display, time date, moon phase, temperature, and camera ID. SD card management. SMI IR video, we have 16.9 widescreen images, Aluna smart technology automatically. Adjustable IR flash for perfect nighttime photos. We have 12 volt external power port, shot still images, 1600 by 900 HD video with sound. Yeah, it takes 5 seconds to 2 minutes, 0.6 second picture recovery time. 4 picture resolutions, selectable delay between images. Got 1 second, 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and 1 minute, 5 minute, 10 minute, 30 minute, or 60 minutes. AIM test mode, we have a 1 year warranty. So far this camera looks great, so let's go ahead and unbox this camera. What comes in the box is your 6 foot strap, your camera, and then your instructions. On the side, there's a latch. You pull up, this whole thing opens up. Right here displays what model this camera is, has brand's customer service, their phone number, their website. On the bottom is a tripod mount. This right here is a tray It's where your batteries go. Push the eject button. This whole thing comes out. Put your batteries in and push this back in. Make sure you hear it lock. There you go. This is where your SD card goes. This is where your 12 volt external power port is. This right here is your eject button, on off switch, and for menu. And then this is your programming buttons. Okay, you have right, down, left, up. You have LCD screen right here. And then you have your microphone right here. This is your camera lens. This is your aim LEDs. And then this is your light sensor. This is your PIR sensor. This right here on the sides is your IR LEDs. And then go ahead and latch this over. Make sure you hear it click. There you go. This is where you put your strap through. This is where you put your security cable through. On the top, there's an antenna right here. But there's one thing about this camera I really like is that, because I had to have like bears and elk actually try to bite it off. So that's really nice. Here's the side, back, other side, bottom, front. Here's a couple things you need before you set your camera up. You'll need your camera. You'll need your SD card. 128 gig is what I'm using by Sendez. I've had good luck with that brand. And then you'll need 8 alkaline or lithium batteries. I'm using 8 Rayvac high energy alkaline batteries. Let's go ahead and put our batteries inside our camera. Make sure you hear that lock. There you go. Then SD card goes right here. Make sure you hear that lock. There you go. Next thing you need to do is pick your carrier. I'm gonna pick Verizon. That's where the strongest cell reception for this camera will be, where I put this in the mountains. So go ahead and turn on your camera, push the mode button. It's gonna ask LTE network, AT&T or Verizon, and then push over and push okay. Then it's gonna ask you one more time, N for no and Y for yes. And then we'll go to Y. Then there is my QR code. Let me show you how you set your camera up so it's non-cell reception, so it'll take pictures. So first off, you need to turn off your cell reception. So let me show you how that works. So go ahead and turn on your camera, push the mode button, and then go down to LTE. It's gonna say Verizon network. It's gonna say on. You wanna change that to off. You can go over or left and then push okay. Now your camera is has non-cell reception, it's not connected. So after that, you wanna go ahead and push the mode button. And then right here, this is the date. You wanna put the date, go ahead and push okay, go up and down as you need to, and then right and left. Today is May 29th, 2022. Go ahead and push that down. And then this is the time, this is important. Right now it is 8:07 p.m. So we'll leave that there. You can go up and down as you need to, right and left. And then we'll keep going down. Mode, this is trail mode. So you got a video or trail, we'll leave it on trail. That's pictures. Capture delay, this is an important setting. So you push okay, and then if you go over, it'll change. 1 minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you got 30 minutes, 60 minutes. 1 second, 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, or 1 minute. So I'll leave it on 1 minute. And then right here, picture size, you can change that to ultra is 20, low is 2 MP, medium is 4 MP, and then high is 8. I'll leave it on ultra, then go down. Multi-shot, you can leave it off if you like. So what that means is, so when animal comes by, I'll take how many pictures. So if I go, this is a 2 standard shot, I'll just take 2 pictures right after another. And then you can change it to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or this is a rapid fire shot, so it's faster, and that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then you can turn it off if you like. I'll leave it on rapid fire shots, 8 shot. So push okay. Then go back down, Smite IR video. I'll talk more about that during the videos in just a little bit. IR flash power, you can change this too. This is how far the flash gets out. This applies to pitchers. You can do fast motion, power saver, or long range. I leave it on long range because sometimes the animals come really close. Trigger speed, normal, fast. I'll leave it on fast. Temperature unit, you got Fahrenheit or Celsius. I'll leave it on Fahrenheit. All depends where you live. Info strip, I leave it on. That's the little thing on the pictures and videos. It says the time, date, and then moon phase and camera ID. I leave it on. SD management, what that means is after the SD card fills up with pictures and videos, it won't take any more if it's on off. Now, if you leave it on, it'll just rewrite over those pictures or those videos and just take them and erase them. So that's what that SD card management does. I'm gonna leave it on off. Motion detection, you can change this to normal or long range. I'll leave it on long range. Motion test, you wanna make sure your camera's working, so go ahead and push the okay, and then on top left, you'll take your hand and that light should come on. That means your camera's working. I know it's a new camera, but I always double check. Go ahead and push okay, and then go down to camera name. You can go up and down as you need to, right and left. Go ahead and push the okay, and then you can change it. Now there's a space between the Z and zero. That's how you make a space. I just take more time on this. You just want to make sure you know what camera is taking pictures or videos. Set default, I push, this is no, I'm going to push no on that because that'll go back to the manufacturer settings on this camera. So I want to save the settings that I have right now. So after that, all you need to do is push the mode button. It says trail, countdown, then this is how many pictures it's got. This is how many it can take on this SD card. Then there's your battery life. Look out for my next review on how to set your camera up so it'll take videos, non-cell reception. Let me show you how you set your camera up so it'll take videos. Now this is non-cell reception. So go ahead and turn your camera, push the mode button. Your cell reception's off. I want to go down to mode, then change this to videos. And then push the enter button, okay. And then this right here is capture delay. You can change that if you like. Now, what capture delay means is when at certain times it's ready to take a video. So every 1 second's ready to take a video, 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, or 60 minutes. I'm gonna leave it on 1 second. So this camera is ready to take a video every 1 second. Then push enter and then go down. Video quality, you can change this to ultra or high. I'll leave it on ultra. Video length, you can change this to 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute or 2 minutes. I'm gonna leave it on every 1 minute. Smite IR, make sure that's on. And then after that, all you gotta do is push the mode button, video, countdown, this is how many videos it's got on the SD card, this is how many it can take. And then this is your battery life. So let's go ahead and get this camera set up so it'll be in cell reception. So after you create an account and sign in, on the bottom left, you have images, cameras, and then right here I have a camera already on this plan. And then right here on the bottom right is settings. This is notifications, my subscriptions, edit categories, sign in, preferences, and then log out. We're going to go down to cameras. And then right here on the top right, there's a plus sign, go ahead and push that. Then you need to go to this right here, add camera. And then I usually exit this little pop-up because I want to make sure this goes to the right subscription on my plan. I made this mistake the first time I tried this. Offline camera, you want to make sure you go down to your monthly subscription. So mine's a Guide Pro. What you want to do is go ahead and push right here and add this camera to this plan. Now that is where you need to scan your QR code on your camera. So let me show you how that works. The next thing you need to do is turn on your cell reception on your camera. So go ahead and turn on your camera, push the mode button. And then this is LTE. That means it's off my network. So I need to change that to on. Go ahead and push that and then push OK. Now that's your QR code. That's what I'm going to scan with my phone. So let's go ahead and do that. After you scan your QR code on your camera, go down and make sure you put in enter camera nickname. You got to have a nickname. So I'm going to call it like camera 2. You can change this later if you like. Now make sure the network matches with your camera. I'm with Verizon, so I'm going to leave it there. And then go ahead and push add camera. So your camera just got added. So let me show you how you put it on the right subscription. Right now it's on offline camera available. I'm not sure why it's doing that. So we'll go to camera, push that. And then what you want to do is go up to the top. This is my plan. So it's on Guide Pro. So push Guide Pro. And then on the bottom says update camera. So go ahead and push that. And then now my camera is successfully updated. And then all I gotta do next is go ahead and review and pay. And so we'll go ahead and push that. And then so it's $5 a month extra on what I'm paying. That's really not too bad. Go ahead and put your credit card information in. And then we'll go ahead and talk more about the app. So let's go ahead and do that. Before we talk about the app, we need to make sure we do an LTE test. So go ahead and turn on your camera. I want to make sure our cell reception is good. So push the mode button and then go LTE, OK, test, push OK. And then it's going to start, search. Looks like we've got cell reception. Those are the bars. Then just upload it, send. And then it's done. Now give it some time. Sometimes this takes a little bit, especially the first time when you boot it up. Sometimes it takes a little bit less than or more than 5 minutes. If you're having trouble, I call Browning's customer service and see if they can help you out. I did have a little trouble with mine. The Verizon network was not working at first, so I had to switch it over to AT&T. It was working, and then I switched it back over to Verizon, and now it works fine. So let's go ahead and talk about the app now and how you control the app with your phone or your device or your computer. Go ahead and open the app and go to cameras right here and then go ahead and push that. And this is the camera. Looks like we got my camera last synced June 22nd at 7:03 p.m. This is my plan right there. This is my status right here. This is my battery life, signal, storage, subscription, settings. This right here is my thumbnail usage. This will go around as you use it. It'll show how much, how many pictures you have left through the pay cycle. So that's how that works. It's pretty cool. And then this is the HD upload usage. And then this is video. We don't have to worry about that. And then we'll go to settings right here. You can change the name anytime you like. Operation mode. It's pretty easy. Push trail. It can go to video, but just keep this in mind. If you do that, it won't transfer those videos to the app. It'll save them on the SD card. So if you like to, you can do that. But I'll just leave it at a trail. So I'll just take pictures. So we'll go ahead and push done. Then we'll go up to temperature unit, Fahrenheit, we'll leave it there. SD management, you can turn that on if you like. Image data strip, I'm gonna leave that on. And then trigger speed, it's at normal right now. We're gonna change that to fast. And then up here, push done. And then we got automatic time zone, or you can do manual. I'll do automatic. So you can control the sync schedule and then thumbnail uploads. I like to schedule it. You can schedule different times, or you can add to if you like, or take away. And then when you're done there, go ahead and push done. And then go to thumbnail uploads. And now you can change this too if you like, to schedule or immediately. I like it on immediately because I like to know what's going on, like with my camera. Do keep in mind, if you do that a lot, it will make the batteries go down. But this camera is made to last a year, and that's what they advertise, so that's pretty cool. Photo quality, you can change it to low. You can go to a medium or high or ultra. I'm gonna leave it on ultra, and then make sure you push done. And then photo delay, I'm gonna leave this on every 1 second. So my camera is ready after it takes 3 shots. It's ready every 1 second to take a picture. And you can adjust that if you like, but I wanna make sure my camera is always ready because the animals come fast, and I'm gonna leave it on 1 second. And then after that, you have multi-shots. You can change this too. You got 8-shot standard, or you got off, or you got 8 rapid-fire shots. I'm gonna leave mine on 8 rapid-fire shots. So that's the fastest, so we'll leave it there. And then after that, you got IR flash power. You can leave that on power saver, long range, fast motion. Power saver is pretty good, but I would leave it on fast motion. That's what I like. So these are the video settings. Now do keep in mind, the video settings, it won't transfer to the app. It will be on the SD card. So you have video quality. You can change that if you like. You have your video length, and then your Smite IR video. And then right here is your SD card. Storage, and if you push that, it'll actually go to this little storage there, and it looks like I don't have much at all right now, so 0, and you can delete all the storage there. Now if you do delete that, it'll be saved on the SD card, so do keep that in mind. I've had that question, people have asked that question, so that's one thing right there. And then right here, it's restore default settings. If you push that button, it'll reset the settings that you started with this camera on the app. And so that's what that does. So far, this camera has been great. The app's easy to use and it's easy to follow. So I really like that part. I'm excited to use this in the mountains. One thing I would recommend before taking this to the mountains or the woods is to test it out at your house. Leave it out for a day where there's motion, and just make sure it works. I like to do this for fun. I'm not paid or anything, or I'm not sponsored. So I just enjoy helping people out, enjoy cameras and mountains. So go ahead and help me out by subscribing to my channel, like my videos, and look out for my next review on how this camera performs in the mountains. And follow me on social media. Thanks for watching.